name is Juan Ayala, and I'm a technical architect at 3Share. I specialize in the Adobe Experience Manager platform. In this video, I'm going to cover error handling in AEM. This is one of the oldest topics in AEM and computer science in general. So why do we want to customize it? First, we don't want to give too much information. Giving as little as the words Apache Sling to attackers might give them clues about your platform, and stack traces expose way too much detail about your software. Second, error pages should be branded and friendly. If you wind up at a page that looks like this, there's nothing to keep that user on your site. It's a dead end. Third, content authors should be able to make content updates. Error pages contain content, sometimes in different languages. They should be updatable like any other page on the site. And finally, you want to look like a pro. If error pages look like this, users aren't going to trust you. I wouldn't give you my password or credit card information. Let's get started. For this lab, I have set up a local AEM author and publisher using the Cloud SDK with Java 11. I have also extracted the dispatcher tools bundled with the SDK. It's all well documented on the Adobe site. Here is my local author and publisher with no content in the dispatcher tools directory. I'm going to create a plain archetype project now, setting the AEM version to cloud. Now that I have the archetype project created and imported into IntelliJ, I'm going to create two run configurations. The first one will be so that I can deploy the entire application package onto the author instance using the auto-install single package profile. And the second one will be so that I can do the same onto the publish using the auto-install single package publish profile. I'm going to get everything deployed onto the author instance. And then I'm going to get everything deployed onto the publish instance. I will need two content pages, one for the 500 internal server errors and the other for the 404 not found errors. These are simple content pages. I'm going to create them using the sample template that was created with the Architect project. First, I will create an errors landing page. Underneath the errors page, I will create a 404 page. The title can be friendly, but the name of the node must be 404. I'm also going to create a 500 error page next to the 404 page. Next, I'm going to use a manage publication wizard to publish the error pages. Within the wizard, I will have the option to publish the tree by including all the children. The wizard replaces a classic UI tree activation wizard that is now deprecated in the cloud service. Finally, I verify that the error pages have been published by checking CRXDE on the publish instance. Now that our content is published, I'm going to start up the local dispatcher. I'm going to open up the cache folder to keep an eye on the files that get cached. I start the dispatcher with a trace1 level. I access a page that doesn't exist. This is a default 404 response from the publisher. When I view the page that doesn't exist on the publisher, I get the same content. This is the way the dispatcher will get the error code and content from the publisher. The user will request a page. The dispatcher doesn't have it, so it will request it from the publisher. The publisher doesn't have it, so it will return a 404 with content. The dispatcher deems that it's not cacheable and will serve it back up to the user. We are going to customize the way Sling generates the error content. We are going to be doing this by setting up the ACS Commons error page handler. Based on the error code it intercepts, it will pull up the corresponding content page from the errors content path.
I'm going to embed the ACS application content packages into my own deployment package. Next, I'm going to create a file to overlay the advanced tab of the basic page template. Then I create the files to overlay Sling's error handler scripts. You will find the contents you need on the ACS error handler documentation page. The advanced folder must be a Sling folder. We only need to define a single required field in the tab overlay. It will leverage a Sling resource merger to wedge the field into place. And finally, I update the filter XML to include the two new overlay paths. I'm going to get everything deployed onto the author instance. I'm going to kick off the publish instance build, and while that runs, I'm going to update the page property on the author. I open up the properties dialog on the language group page and select the advanced tab. This is where that tab overlay was merged. I set the path to the error pages so that any error generated under this language group will pull error content from that location. Now, when I try to access a page that doesn't exist on the author, I see the 404 content. When I try the same on the publisher, I still see the default content. That's because the page property hasn't been published. All I need to do is a quick publish on the language root page. I verify that the page property was published. And finally, when I try to access a page that doesn't exist, Sling will send back a 404 content. We are now going to set up error handling in Apache. This is how it works. The user will request a page. The dispatcher doesn't have it, so it will request it from the publisher. The publisher doesn't have it, so it will return a 404 with content. This is where it gets different from the first setup. Instead of sending the 404 code and content back to the user, Apache will look to see what content it should use for the current error code. It makes a request back to the publisher for the error page. The publisher responds with the error content. It should always be an OK response. The dispatcher will now cache the content for the error code before serving it back to the user. If the error code is ever encountered again, it will pull up the content from cache instead of making a call back to the publish. Let's start with the dispatcher so we can make updates to the Apache configuration. Since the default vhost is immutable, I need to create a new vhost based on the default. Now I create a symlink to enable a new vhost. I am prefixing it with 01 to ensure it goes ahead of the default vhost. The default vhost should always go last. Now that I have a vhost, I can start making updates. First, I'm going to instruct the dispatcher module to delegate all errors to Apache. I do this by setting the dispatcher pass error parameter to 1. Now I need to tell Apache where to find the error content by using the error document directives. I am done with my Apache configuration, so I'm going to start the dispatcher back up. I load localhost 8080 in the browser. Before I go any further, I notice that there is a login token cookie. When this is present, the dispatcher will not cache anything. So I'm going to open up an incognito window. When I navigate back to the page that doesn't exist, I get back the 404 content. I can verify in my cache directory that the 404 page is now there. And I can verify in the log that the cache action was to create. I reload the browser. And now I see in the log that the cache action was to deliver. This means it found the page in the cache and there was no callback to the publish.
Although you can set up both ways of error handling, you only really need one. My personal preference is to do it in Apache. The configuration is super simple, and it takes advantage of the dispatcher caching. Thanks for watching.